Hi guys, my name is Rohit and in this video, I will show you how you can create a beautiful overlapping column effect in your WordPress website just by using a free version of Elementor. So first of all, let me just show you what I mean by overlapping columns. So we have this. If I scroll down, we can see here, we have this beautiful image at the background and this column, we can say a text column here at the front, which overlaps the image at the background. Let me make it more visible to you. So now you can see we have this, and then if I scroll down, we have this image. This image here moves with our content. If I scroll down, it moves up. If I scroll up, it moves down. But here this image stays at the same position where it is. So now if I move down again, we have this beautiful image here also. This image is also fixed and our content moves up and down when we slide our cursor through this. So now let me just show you how you can also achieve this thing. So first of all, what you need to do, you need to open Elementor in the page you want to edit and have some changes like this. I am gonna show you right here in this page. So I will just click over this plus icon here and then I will have this section. Now what you need to do, you need to go to this part here and select inner section, drag inner section here. Let me just put a spacer also here at the bottom of this inner section like this. Now, first thing you need to do here, you need to just click over the inner section here. You need to go to column gaps and make it no gap. And then what you need to do, you need to have your content part here at the left hand side. So I will just copy this content part from here in this manner and I will directly paste it here like this. So I am assuming that you already know how to deal with all this stuff, how to have headings in your section, how to have text and call to action like this. So I am only proceeding with the overlapping part here. Some of you might be thinking that it can be achieved by a negative margin. So first of all, let me just show you what it will look like when we do negative margin thing. So I will click over here and let me insert an image here, image widget here. And now if I, upload the same image that I have used, for example, this one, and if I insert this, this image will look like this and our content will look like this. This image height is kind of smaller as compared to this column, so we can't achieve this by this effect. So rather what I can do, I can just delete this one and I can have a background image at this column. So if I click over this column and I go to style, here at the background we have classic. You can choose an image here. I will go to media and select the same image. And then here at the left hand side, I can decide few things. Its position, I will make it center. And its size, I can make it cover like this. So now we can see here we have our image and we have our column text. So we can adjust few things now. If I go to this column here at the text column, and I go to advance, and then if I first unlink this and have a top margin of 200 or rather 150 in this manner, and the bottom margin also of 150. So now what we have this beautiful image at the right, which is kind of bigger as compared to this text column. And then at the right hand side we can have a negative margin. So I will prefer here negative margin of 100, but you can see here it doesn't change at all. So we need to have an equal amount of left margin also, but in a positive value. So I will put here positive 100. Here you can see we have a z index of 1. If we put here z index 0, then our image will overlap the content at left. But we want our content to overlap the image, so we have to make it 1. It will look like this. So if I hide this window and make it little smaller, control minus once, control minus, like this. So now this will look something like this. But you can see here, if I scroll down, we have a little bit of difference when we see these two sections. Here in this section we have positive 100 margin from left, so it is slightly shifted towards the right, and here at the left we have more margin and the right we have less margin. But in this image we can see we have equal margin from left and right as well. This means that we cannot achieve this thing by simply doing stuff like negative margin. So how can you do that in a proper manner? So I will open this window again. Let me make it control 0 back to normal. And now what I can do here, I can just click over this column again and back to normal position. Let me just have a new column here and I will delete this column. So if you want to have the same effect like this that we have below, how can you achieve this effect? You need to select the inner section, go to style and have a background image that we have chosen before. I will select this one, insert media, and now we will have a background image in this entire section. So here at the left hand side, change few things, make position to center if you want. Repeat to, I will set it to no repeat. Size I can make it cover and it will be shown something like this. Or rather what I can do, I can make its position center right, or you can say center left, like this. And now we have this image and the text column here. Now what we can do, we can just go to advanced in the same section, inner section, and we can have top and bottom padding. So if I increase the top padding to 100, we will have something like this, and if I increase the bottom padding also, we will have something like this. Now what we can do, we need to go to style again and we need to go to background overlay, choose gradient here and choose first color white, or whatever color your, you know, website background have, choose that color. Second color is totally depends upon you. Now set the first color's location to 30 and second color location to 0. Then you will have something like this. Set the type to linear, angle to 90 and opacity to 1. Then you will have something like this. Now choose the second color and make it fully transparent. And then if you see this, it will be shown something like this. And if I zoom out a bit, it will be shown something like this. So this is what we want. You can see here we have the equal margin from left and right as well, as we have in these other images also. And now what we want something like this. If we scroll up and down, this image should stick to the same position and rest of the content should move. So how can we do that? So we need to select the inner section again and go to background. Here at the image we have something called attachment. So choose the attachment to fix, and now if I see this, if I scroll down, this image is fixed now and rest of the content is moving. If I press control minus minus, so this is how it will look. And that's it. That's how you can do that. But let me just show you a few other things also. If I press control 0 here and I select response mode and I go to tablet, this is how it will look on tablet. And that's not very much pretty. So how can you fix this thing in your tablet, and how can you make this thing mobile friendly also? If I go to mobile, you can see here this is showing something like this. It's quite ugly. So what we can do here, just we can go to tablet again and we can make a duplicate of this section in this manner, or rather Let me just cancel this for now. We can duplicate the outer section, you know, bigger one. So let me duplicate this one. Now if I select the first section, go to advance, and here at the bottom we have responsive. Just click over hide on tablet and hide on mobile. So it will not be shown on your tablet and mobile devices. It will only be shown to your desktop. And the second one, hit over the second one and go to advanced again. Click over responsive and hide this one on desktop. Now what you can do, you can go to inner section here at the, you know, tablet one, and then go to style again and make it colored like this. Or you can go to background overlay and change it to classic rather than a gradient. And also what you can do, you can have that image here as well. Now select the image, just press over the image, choose the image and click on insert media. Now you will have the image like this. And what I want here, I don't want this text to be this much lengthy, so I can click over this heading. Rather, first what I can do, I can click over this column here, I can go to advance, unlink the padding, link it again, increase it. Okay, this much is fine. And now hit over the title and go to style, change its size. I think this much is fine. Also, you can change the content size. Just hit over content, go to style, hit typography, and you can have a different size. So let me make it 14 for now. And that's it. Now what you can do, you can have this view at your, you know, tablet devices. And if I check this thing on your, you know, mobile devices, so this is how it will look. Now it's quite pretty and it looks fine. Update it and let me just show you in your desktop again. So this is how it will look on your desktop. And if I hide this window, this is how it will look. Similarly, if I show you this thing on your tablet, if I hide this window, so this is how it will look on your mobile devices. So that's fine for mobile devices because we can't have two columns one after another in our mobile devices due to the lack of horizontal space. So that's fine for mobile devices, but for desktop you have a beautiful design like this one. So that's it for now. If you like this video, give this video a thumbs up. And if you are new here, then please make sure to subscribe to my channel for more upcoming awesome content. So that's it. Thank you so much.